Hello everyone, my name is Gitanjali Singh and I'm currently interning at Lexis & Company. The topic for today's video is section 482 of CRPC, the inherent powers of the High Court. First of all, we give the introduction and background of section 482 and then its essential, the exceptions for it and then the landmark cases around it. Now, first of all, the essential object of a criminal law is to protect society against a criminal or the criminal offenders who have done wrong against the society as a whole. For this purpose, the law holds out threats of punishment to prospective lawbreakers as well as attempts to make the actual offender suffer the prescribed punishment that has been given under Indian law in IPC or CRPCs respectively. Therefore, criminal law in its wider sense consists of both the substantive criminal law and procedural criminal law. Now this CRPC also controls and regulates the working of the machinery set up by the investigation of trial of offences. It has, however, been declared by Supreme Court that the subordinate court do not have any inherent powers. But the High Court has the inherent power and they have been partially given statutory recognition by enacting section 482 of this code by the amendment of this act. Now the background of section 482, the power to coercion FIR, that is first information report, is among the inherent power of High Court of India. Court possessed this power even before the Criminal Procedure Code was enacted. Added as section 482 by an amendment in 1923, it is a reproduction of the section of 561A of 1898 code. Since High Court could not render justice even in cases which the illegal was apparent, the section was created as a reminder to the court that they exist to prevent injustice done by the subordinate courts and to prevail the justice over injustice. Nothing in this code shall be deemed to limit or affect the inherent powers of the High Court to make such order as may be necessary to give effect to any order under the code or to prevent abuse of the process of any court or otherwise secure the ends of the justice. Now, the exercise of power of section 482 of CRPC is the exception and not the rule. Inherent power under section 482 CRPC may be exercised to give effect to an order under the court to prevent abuse and the process of the court to otherwise secure the ends of the justice. The purpose behind its incorporation was this section makes clear that the provision of the code are as to intend to limit or affect the inherent powers of the High Court. Obviously, the inherent powers can be exercised only for either three purposes specifically mentioned in the sections that has been explained above. Lacunes are sometimes discovered in the procedural law, and it is the purpose for covering such lacunes, dealing with such cases where such lacunes are discovered, the procedural law invariably recognizes the existence of such inherent powers in the court. Here, it is extremely important to be noticed that only the High Court, whose inherent power has been recognized by Section 482, even in regards to the High Court's inherent power definite, statutory safeguards have been laid down as to its exercise. It is only where the High Court is satisfied either that an order passed under the code would be rendered ineffective or that the process of any court would be abused or that the ends of justice would not be secured and that the High Court can and must exercise its inherent power under Section 482 of this code. In the case of state of Karnataka versus Muniswamy, the Honorable Supreme Court held that the section envisages three circumstances in which inherent jurisdiction may be exercised, namely to give effect an order CRPC, to prevent the abuse of process of the court, and to secure the ends of the justice. The Honorable Allahabad Court went on to state that the section is a sort of reminder to the High Court that they are not merely the court in law, but also the courts of justice that possesses the inherent powers to remove injustice. The inherent power of High Court is an inalienable attribute of the position it holds with respect to the courts, subordinate to it. They are necessarily judicial when they are exercisable with respect to judicial orders and for securing the ends of justice. Now, what are the real powers of the High Court under Section 482 of CRPC? Inherent powers under Section 482 of CRPC includes power to quash FIR, investigation or any criminal proceedings pending before High Court or any court subordinate to it, and are wide magnitude and ramifications. Such powers can be exercised to secure the ends of the justice and to prevent any abuse of the powers or process of any subordinate courts in terms of corruption or any, and can make any such orders as may be necessary as to deem fit to give effect to any order under this court. Depending upon the facts of a case, court can always take notes of any miscarriage of justice and prevent the same by exercising its power as an inherent power given under Section 482 of CRPC. These powers are neither limited or nor curtailed by any other provisions of the code. However, such inherent powers are exercised primarily with the cautions. However, High Court does not have interlocutory power to interfere between any criminal proceeding that has been going under subordinate court, but High Court is under an obligation to interfere if there is a harassment of any person by illegal prosecution. It would also be so when an exceptional or extraordinary reason are there for giving so. In the case of Madhu Limai versus Maharashtra, the Supreme Court has said that nothing in the code, not even Section 397, can affect the amplitude of the inherent power preserved in Section 482. Further, the Supreme Court held the following principles that would govern the exercise of inherent jurisdiction of High Court. Power is not to be resorted to if there is a specific provision in the code for redress of grievances of aggrieved party. It should be exercised primarily to prevent abuse of process of any court or otherwise to secure the ends of the justice. It should not be exercised against the express bar of the law engrafted in any other provision of this code. It can never be laid down more particularly or precisely when the High Court can or cannot use its power, but attempts have been made on the behalf of in several decisions by the Supreme Court. Many of the cases came and gave the following principles where High Court can exercise its inherent power and when it cannot interfere between the proceedings that has been going under its subordinate court or not. Now, the reasons where High Court can interfere and the famous cases where the principles were laid down will be dealt in another video.